Hey everyone, I bought a MacBook Pro, so now I can make Flipper Zero videos for the Mac. In this video, we're going to be looking at how to set up your Flipper Zero. And for that, you'll need an SD card, like this one I have from Rabbit Labs. And you'll also need a USB-C to USB 3.1 adapter, so that you can use the supplied cable. Or if you have a USB-C with USB-C, you can use that as well. In this video, we'll be looking at how to install the official firmware, as well as RogueMaster, Unleashed, and Momentum. Let's get started. Okay, so the first step is take an SD card and make sure that the pins are facing up, and then insert it into your Flipper Zero. Push it in with your thumbnail and then pull off the sticker. And then you'll hold the back button for 3 seconds. And there it says, "Hey mate, press right to continue. Allow me to introduce myself." It'll tell you the name of your flipper. "I can grow smart and cool if you use me often. As long as you read, write, and emulate, you can check my level and mood in the passport menu." And then it says, "No databases found on SD card." And then it tells you to go to flipp.dev/UPD. And that's actually also the same as going to update.flipper0.1. Okay, so next we'll take this adapter and put it on our cable that was provided by the flipper. And then we'll plug this into our USB port on the side. And then we'll plug our flipper into the other side. And you'll see that we now get this allow accessory to connect message and go ahead and say allow. So before we get too far along, I recommend you go to docs.flipper.net and read all the great topics that are there. In particular, at least read the basics and each of the protocols that you plan on using. And when you click into one, if you make sure that your browser is full width, you'll also see the table of contents on the left side. So next, let's load that flipp.dev/UPD. Or you could load the flipper0.1/update. And in here, there's a link to both the mobile app and also the desktop application. Go ahead and download the desktop application. And then once it's done, I'll go ahead and open that. And then we'll drag qFlipper into applications. And then once that's done, we can bring up Finder and we can eject the qFlipper. Okay, next we can go into Launchpad and we should see qFlipper. Go ahead and open that. And qFlipper is an app downloaded. Are you sure you want to open it? Open. And there is our flipper. Go ahead and click Update and Update. I'll go ahead and speed up this part of the video. And then once your files are transferred to the Flipper Zero, you'll need to look at your Flipper Zero screen to see the rest of the progress. And this update process will also take a few minutes while it updates everything on the Flipper Zero. Okay, and we got that success message. And then back on our desktop, we have this allow accessory to connect again. Go ahead and say allow. And we see the success message. And at this point, you should see no updates, and you're running the latest firmware. This is the latest release firmware. If you wanted to run the release candidate, which is the next version that's coming out, or the latest development change, you could choose one of those as well and update to it. So the basic firmware has sub gigahertz, RFID, NFC, infrared, GPIO, iButton, bad USB, and U to F for authentication. And then in apps, it only has a few apps like a Bluetooth remote, the main GPIO app, the snake game, etc. And so you can close qFlipper and then go to lab.flipper.net. Go ahead and make sure you're in Chrome as your browser, and then say connect. And then we'll go ahead and click on our Flipper and say connect. And at this point, lab.flipper.net is able to see all the details about our Flipper. From here, you could also update your firmware just like we did in qFlipper. But under apps is a bunch of other applications that you can install for your Flipper Zero. So I'll go ahead and install the banana. And when we click on it, you'll see what category it's in. So it says games in this case. And then there's a description that sometimes helps you understand what the application's for. So go ahead and say install. Okay, and that's installed. So we have to close lab.flipper.net. And now that it's closed, I'll go command space and type in qFlipper, say open, and I'll back out to the main menu. And so now under apps, games, we now have banana. Go ahead and start. And there's Banana. Once you're done exploring official firmware with the apps from the lab.flipper.net, you can try installing the Unleashed firmware or the RogueMaster firmware or the Momentum firmware. People are always asking which firmware is the best. And the answer is it depends on what you want to do. So go ahead and feel free to try each of them and see what you like the best for how you want to use your Flipper Zero. Okay, so let's go ahead and look at one of the ways we can install Unleashed firmware once we've updated our Flipper. We'll go ahead and click on the install. That'll bring us over to their GitHub. And then in GitHub is releases, and this will list out what's in the release. Here's how you can support the project. And then finally, what you're going to want to look at is, do you want just the base applications or not? Do you want the extra applications? And did you install the RGB mod for your Flipper Zero? Most people have not installed the RGB mod. So they probably want to try the extra applications to get the most out of Unleashed. So that's the E version. So then that means we're going to go down to Extra Apps E. And then you'll just go ahead and click install. I'll go ahead and do it now. For custom firmwares, this takes even longer than official. And again, once it's copied those files, you'll need to look at the Flipper Zero screen to see the rest of the progress. And for custom firmware, this part of the install takes a long time too, since it has to install all those extra applications as well as the firmware. It looks like we just finished installing. And then once it's finished, we'll go ahead and say allow accessory to connect. And then it may take a few seconds while it redetects the device. And you can see that we're now running unleashed firmware. I'll go ahead and close Flipper Lab. And then I'll do command space qFlipper. And then we'll use the right arrow key to click through the different welcome screens. There's the link to their Discord. I recommend if you're running Unleashed or whatever firmware you choose that you join their Discord server. And so now when we go into apps and games, you can see that there's a lot more applications than just banana and snake. Okay, I'll go ahead and close qFlipper. Next, let's take a look at RogueMaster firmware. And on RogueMaster, they're using Patreon for the way to support the firmware developer. And if you go into GitHub, here's the web installer. And again, you should join their Discord server if you're using their firmware. And similar to Unleashed, they're using the same web installer, and we would just click install. I'll go ahead and do that now. And again, this process is similar to the other firmware, does take quite a while. I'll go ahead and cut to the end of the file transfer. And RogueMaster typically includes the most applications of all the firmwares, so it typically takes the longest to install. So I'll go ahead and cut to the end of the install process. There's our success message. Okay, and then back on our desktop, we'll go ahead and say allow accessory to connect. And again, it'll take a few seconds to reconnect. And there we are. We've updated our firmware. I'll go ahead and close lab.flipper.net and do command space qFlipper open. And so there's the link to the Discord server. And now we have RogueMaster installed. Okay, so go ahead and close qFlipper. And then we'll go to Momentum. And here's the link to donate to this firmware. And again, a link to the Discord server. I'll go ahead and just click install from here. And you see that they're using a custom installer. And again, this will require Chrome or another browser that supports serial. Go ahead and select our Flipper Zero, say connect. And then you can choose if you want the current release build, which has gone through all the QA process, or if you want dev, which has the very latest features. But may have a few issues still. So I'll go ahead and do release. And then we'll choose flash. And similar to the other firmware installers, this will copy all the files onto your Flipper Zero. And this does take a few minutes. And then once it's done copying those files, the rest of the status will be on your Flipper Zero. And we'll go ahead and jump to the end of the install. And there's that welcome message. Okay, and then we'll go ahead and say allow accessory to connect. And then I'll close the tab with the Momentum firmware dev update. And then we'll do command space qFlipper. And then here's the various Momentum introduction screens. And you'll notice the default layout on Momentum is a little bit different for the main menu. And then we can edit all of our Momentum settings as well. I'll go ahead and switch the asset pack to Momentum. And then when we back out, there's the Momentum logo. Thanks for watching this video on how to set up your MacBook with your Flipper Zero. In a future video, I'll do one on how to set up Visual Studio Code with the MacBook, and we'll edit an application on the Flipper Zero. Please like and subscribe, and if you have any comments or questions, please leave them below.